Hello everyone. Today I'd like to show you how I build the scope adapter portion of my night vision scopes. In the last video, we built the camera module. I'll need to build a scope adapter that will bolt on the front of the camera module and receive the scope. First thing I need to do is take a measurement of the end of the scope that the adapter will slide over. Okay, I'm getting around 37.5. And I think I'll go with, give it a little bit of clearance, I'll go with 37.65. So I'll write that down. The next step is going to be to edit the 123D design file to fit that scope adapter.
Okay, I'm in 123D design now. Starting with the blank scope adapter piece, and I need to edit this piece so that it looks more like a finished piece like this. So I'm going to edit the circles first in the sketch, and I think I'll go ahead and turn off the solids. My measurement was 37.65 millimeters. So 37.65. And then I like to put a shelf thickness of about 3 millimeters. So 37.65 plus 6 is 43.65. These two lines all the way across. These two lines will be the relief part that allows the hose clamp to pinch down the adapter to the shaft or to the scope. Turn solids back on so we can see what we're extruding into. And the first thing I need to do is go ahead and extrude this outer ring to the height of this, because if I don't, I'll have an empty spot there. And I don't remember what this is, so I'm going to take a measurement right quick. jump over to this other file because I don't remember what this distance is supposed to be either. Take it. Oh my gosh. Alright, so there's the rough scope adapter. I would put a chamfer along this edge. The bottom of that and right here, but I'm not going to go over that. And we'll put some chamfers and fillets on this, and I'll put it in, put it through Cura, and we'll stick it on the Monhal Duplicator i3, and I'll show you what it looks like 16, 17 hours after.
Okay, here's the scope adapter a couple days later off the Monhal Duplicator i3. And the monitor and infrared flashlight holder. First thing I need to do to prepare this is go ahead and drop in the threaded inserts. These are 5mm threaded inserts, and I need to redraw this to take just a regular 5mm nut, but I haven't done it yet because I have plenty of these inserts, but I will set aside some time to do that. Get these inserts inserted and then bolt it to the camera module. And I bolt it in such a way that these slots here are on the side. These slots will go on the side. This will be the side of the rifle, your wires come on, and your battery pack will hang off the left side. I'll go ahead and screw that together, and then I'll show you how I fit it to the scope. Now that I got the camera module and scope adapter screwed together, I went ahead and hooked up the LCD screen and the battery, powered it up. And we'll see if we can't get this. First, I'll slide the hose clamp down and slide the adapter over the scope. And what we're going to have to do is adjust the eye relief until we can get the reticular into focus. Slide it off, adjust it. That's pretty good. So I'll lock down the scope adapter in that particular spot. try to get this as square on the screen as possible by giving it a little tweaks. That looks pretty good. And I'll give you a close-up of what I'm seeing with the LCD screen. It's a pretty sharp image. All right, next I'll assemble the LCD and flashlight holder onto the scope, and we'll take her outside and do a little test. All right, so here's the finished scope assembly, all ready to go on the rifle. I got it powered with a little 12-volt monitor power supply. I'm using 632 machine screws and a acorn nut. Acorn nut makes it where you're not gonna scratch yourself on any of those ends of those machine screws sticking up. There it is, and we'll take her outside and take a look.